Okay, there's the good word from Borden. And now, one of our contestants is already seated here. Would you tell us your name and where you're from, sir?
My name is Harry Gribben.
Harry Gribben, and your home?
New York City.
And you have a connection with our guest. Ladies and gentlemen, when the story of American humor is written, I'm sure there'll be many chapters devoted to our special guest tonight, Mr. Buster Keaton. Are you feeling okay tonight, Buster? Good. How's your family? They okay? Did you enjoy your trip to Europe? You just got back a couple days ago, didn't you? Well, panel, that's all the information we can give you. And now, for the benefit of our audience, let's make the connection.
Mr. Keaton has thrown pies at over 50 actors, but Mr. Gribben is the only actor who ever threw a pie at Buster.
I'll give you this one link, panel. This is something Mr. Gribben did to Buster, and we'll start the questioning with Betty White.
Was this something that made you happy, Mr. Keaton? Was this something that made you happy, what Mr. Gribben did?
No, yes.
The question was asked of Mr. Keaton.
Chatterbox. Mr. Gribben, did this make you happy?
Did it make you happy?
Yes.
Did it have anything to do with Mr. Keaton as a comedian, with his career?
Oh, yes.
Did you, by any chance, work together at any time?
Yes.
Was this in vaudeville, by any chance, Mr. Keaton?
No.
No? Was it on the stage?
No.
Was it outdoors?
That's $25 down and $125 to go. Gene, what questions do you have?
It's a dirty trick, but how's the family, Mr. Keaton? Mr. Keaton, sir, did he appear with you in any of the early routines, like when they threw custard pies or something like that? Did he ever throw any custard pies at you? Did he throw the first custard pie?
Let me finish.
Did he throw the first custard pie?
You've just about got it. Can you expand on it a little more?
Lemon meringue?
No, not the Mr. Gribben has a distinction. I'm going to give it to you. Very good going, Gene Klavan. Mr. Keaton has thrown hundreds of pies at dozens of top movie actors in Hollywood through the years, but Mr. Gribben has the distinction of being the only actor who ever threw a pie at Buster in a movie. I guess you're pretty proud to have that distinction, aren't you, Mr. Gribben?
No, yes.
You are. Incidentally, you were a Mack Sennett comedian, I understand. Is that right?
That's right.
And what parts did you play?
Oh, I played a silk hat crook. You were? All the police chased.
I see. You were the guy that the cops were always after.
Yeah.
You were certainly a good sport to let them throw all those pies at you, or that one pie. After all, you were the master pie thrower of all time. How did it feel to have the table turned on you? Were you unhappy about it? You know, panel, I spent most of the afternoon talking to Buster and to Mr. Gribben and about Buster's pie-throwing career. We worked out a little thing to show you how Buster became not only a great comedian, but king of the pie-throwers. Would you like to see what we've talked about and worked out here, you would? Hey, that's just the answer we hope you give, because, well, let's have the pie. Shall we get to the business at hand? Let's step right over here. Right. I mean, we've got pies here. Aren't they beautiful? You want to arrange that a little bit differently? The one thing we need, though, Buster, is we need a subject. How about a volunteer from the panel to come up here and stand up here for... Oh, come on!
Well, thank you.
You know, it's all for fun, for laughs.
You know, not me, Buster. This is my program. You know, I...
The dignity of the office and all that sort of thing. Buster's got an idea, and it really would be a shame to let all of these pies go to waste, because, hey, that isn't a bad idea. All right. While you're getting ready there, Buster, I'll get ready down here, and we'll get on with this saga. Mr. Gribben, would you hand me that piece of paper in front of you there? That's a very important manuscript. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to begin the story here of Buster Keaton entitled, How I Learned to Pitch Pies, or I Get a Bang Out of Lemon Meringue.
Buster Keaton was not always the master pie thrower that he is today. Back in 1917, it was an inexperienced and frightened youth who walked on the set of Metro Pictures and was handed his first pie. With trembling hands and a fluttering heart, Buster rose to the occasion. From these tender beginnings, Buster soon rose to international fame. The entertainment world rang with the magic of Buster Keaton's name. Practiced every minute of the day. He threw pies at anyone and everyone. No one was safe from his need for self-expression. Hollywood had created the monster. We certainly would like to point out at this point that the gentleman who played the piano in the pit many times during Buster Keaton's silent motion pictures back in the old days. He scored Cinerama Holiday, he wrote the theme song for this program, and he has a wonderful Mercury album called Academy Award Songs, which I'm certain you'll enjoy hearing. Let's welcome Jack Shanlin, ladies and gentlemen. Buster, I see there are all kinds of pies there, and we have a little time, and I do a little comedy occasionally, not much tonight, but I might want to do some pie throwing sometime. Could you teach me how to throw one of those?
Sure.
You could? Very hard?
No. Here. Stand over here.
All right.
Did you ever throw a grenade?
A hand grenade?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, sure. I've got a pretty good arm, as a matter of fact.
Get the feel of the weight of it.
Yeah?
Get the weight.
All right.
Do the same thing.
Yeah.
Get your direction.
Yeah.
Look behind you.
Put your left hand out like that.
And then look behind you to make sure that there's nothing there to knock it out of your hand.
All right.
Back to your target and bring it over.
I don't know whether you had an opportunity to see the pellets that Mr. Milligan used. Would it be possible? I don't know if you can see this or not. But they're solid steel, ball bearings is what they are, and they're about a half inch in diameter. Almost a half inch, 7/16, as a matter of fact. I used to know a fellow who knocked apples off his wife's head, but he did it the hard way with hand grenades. And it didn't work out so well. One thing I must straighten out, in case there's any confusion in anyone's mind, everything is fine and dandy down at Myrtle Beach. We didn't mean to imply that the town was blown away or anything like that. The damage down there was practically nil this year. And speaking of those two gentlemen who were from Myrtle Beach, I guess we all know what Rosemary Clooney means now when she sings, "Come on to my house." She means bring the whole house and everything. But I believe it's time now to hear a final word or two from our panel. We hope you have a pleasant trip back. Good night, Betty White.
Thank you, Gene, so much. And I think this is Dirty Pool tonight. We have such a lovely guest as Lorraine Day, and we have the most hazardous show we've ever had. Honestly, things aren't always this way. Good night, Gene.
Gene, we'll see you next week, won't we?
I hope so, Gene. I'd like to take this second, if I can, to read a short letter from one of our viewers out there.
All right. Well, thank you very
good
much,
Gene
Clavin. Good night. Lorraine, it was a pleasure to have you with us tonight. A good night to you.
Well, thank you. It was lots of fun, and I would just like to know, do we get to eat the rest of the pies?
That's not a bad idea. I'm with you.
Thank you.
Good night, Lorraine. Eddie, good night to you, sir.
Good night. I think it'd be wonderful if all the people who drink Borden's milk all over the country will run out and get a Stan White High Fidelity set. Because I make them.
Okay, we'll see you all next week, panel, and we know you'll be just as sharp as ever when you come back here to play Make the Connection. Thank you for being with us, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you'll be able to join us next week at this same time. Good night.
This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.